Let's go across to more pleasant things. And I'm joined here in the Delhi studios by Abida Khan, the coach of this team. Today, of course, she had to relinquish her position to none other than legendary Australian cricketer Adam Gilchrist. We're also being joined by Bushra and Farkanda, two members of that team. Thank you very much for joining us, all of you, on the show tonight. Bushra, what was the biggest takeaway of your experience today playing, being coached by Adam Gilchrist? What was the most important thing you learned today?
I learned many things from Adam Gilchrist. It's like a dream come true for you if you're going to meet such legendary player. So, yeah, we learned many things. Yeah, playing with him in his team, it was like a dream come true. So, yeah.
All right, so a dream come true indeed. But Abida, you know, your girls played with two Delhi colleges today. Yeah. You were saying they were mixed teams. Sadly, for a lot of young people, not just in Delhi, but anywhere in India, the perception of young people from Kashmir is that they're protesters, they're stone pelters, they're all out on the streets all the time. How important was it today to engage, to perhaps break those stereotypes, to show them that, you know, you are so much more, and sports perhaps is the way forward?
Obviously, you know, when people talk about why people like that way, it really hurts. But when you come out to play in these kind of situations, it's like you can go to any way wherever you want to go. I'm just not comfortable with that.
So tell us in Hindi if you want.
No, that's okay.
All right. So Farkanda, you tell us, you know, being a woman cricketer is obviously a challenge. Is it more so being a woman cricketer in Kashmir? I mean, you were talking about the incredible difficulties you face when it comes to infrastructure as well.
Yeah, actually, you know, first of all, I just want to, you know, convey this message to our international players, right? Gilchrist, okay, fine. He's not from India, right?
He's from Australia.
He's coming all along from Australia to Delhi just to see us, Kashmiri people, Kashmiri girls, how we are, like, you know, succeeding in cricket. Why not our own players? They are just tweeting about Kashmir, about the youth of Kashmir. Why don't they come to Kashmir and train us?
They can come forward with a message to our Kashmiri youth. They can train us if they really want to do something for Kashmiri youth, and especially to the women fertility.
Yeah, rather than creating fuss in this, you know, already that place is tense, right? Rather than, you know, like getting that settled and all that, they're just tweeting anything, you know, and...
And you think that this is a real problem for sports people, for players in the valley who want to get on with life in general and feel that this is something political that isn't necessarily even the true picture entirely?
Actually, we are from sports, fine. We don't have to do anything with politics, right? We just want to say we are here just to convey BCCI to, like,
to the higher authorities
of
that
cricket.
What we need from you people is the infrastructure, we need facilities,
we need support, we need matches
so that we can also contribute in this field of games and sports.
What you've been telling me is absolutely astonishing, that not only are there far fewer matches that the BCCI organizes in Kashmir, but also when it comes to facility, you have almost zero infrastructure on the ground.
So
in fact, you're telling me that, you know, you're producing state level players, but you actually don't even have an academy at the moment.
We are producing state level players only because of their own talent. There should be some facilities available to our players, but there is zero kind of facilities there over there. We don't have any academy for training our players over there.
We don't have ground
over there.
So there's no ground, there's no academy. When do you actually train before there's a big tournament?
We do train individually. It's like if you have to train, you have to go your own.
Actually, there's the session of the BCCI starts from September till Feb. And during those periods, we conduct trials for selection of the team, and that is the only procedure what our players go through.
I think it's incredible that you manage to do what you do in spite of those odds. And it isn't just that. It isn't just about the infrastructure and facilities either. Just being a woman and being a cricketer can also be very difficult.
Yeah.
Even if you personally haven't faced that, you have team members who say that they had to hide their cricket bats in their salwar kameez as they were going out to play. How do you change attitudes in the valley when it comes to women playing?
See, it's if your parents are supportive to you, so you can go for anything. If not, then it's very difficult. So it depends on the situation. If the situation is tense there, so they just have to go like that. In villages, they face it, but in cities, it's okay.
They face a lot of problems in villages.
In cities, wouldn't face like that.
So Farkanda, tell me, yesterday, did you watch the match?
Okay, no, actually, no, we were not having any TV.
Our TV
was not
working. In our, you know, house.
We demanded for a TV, but
we were demanding for a TV. Obviously,
it was not working.
It was a big match, so.
But I was told that you managed to live stream it a little on your phones, and so you did in fact get to see a little bit of it after all.
But that was our team was more curious about meeting
Adam
Gilchrist rather than watching the TV.
Yesterday we were like making mind up, we'll do this, we'll have these tips and that tips, like we're busy with that.
So what was it then? What was for you the biggest moment about this day and playing with Adam Gilchrist? And if you had to be coached by an Indian player, who would that person be?
My favorite is Mahendra Singh Dhoni. I would love to, you know, if he's my coach, played by
him.
That's like, but I don't know when, and you know, when that's
when we will get chance,
we'll
to, meet
get chance
those
to meet
players,
him.
Our own players.
And if you had a message for them right now, if the BCCI was listening to this program, what is it that you would tell them?
Our message is this: if Adam Gilchrist, a legend from Australia, can come over here and meet, especially J&K women team, CM 11 team, why not you people? You can give a message to the whole country, to the Kashmiri youth, if you will take some initiative, some training programs for our youth there in the Kashmir Valley.
And that's the best way to get the youth off the streets also?
Yeah.
Obviously, yeah.
You want matches, in short.
You want matches, in short. Yeah. Well, I really hope that message does carry through. And for all of us here, you are an inspiration and continue to play and continue to unify. Nothing unites people more than sports does. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.